Hello, good afternoon, everyone. I am Miss Jane J. Prahernog, and I am an animal science student. So today, we are going to tackle about the famous scientist in the Philippines. So, kasagaran sa to mga nailhan lang scientist is silang Dr. Einstein, silang Dr. Newton, silang Dr. Galileo, and other well-known scientists. Pero within our country, sa Philippines, siguro some of us kay nainailhan, pero gamay ra. So karon, we will explore and discover kung kisa to mga Filipino scientist nga na ay contribution sa tuang country sa Philippines. So first we have Dr. Ramon Cabanos Barba, who is born on August 31, 1939. He is an inventor and horticulturist, and was best known for inventing a way to induce more flowers and mango trees using ethyl and potassium nitrate. So, ang ethyl and potassium nitrate, nanis sila'y, Okay, ang ethyl is a chemical compound that helps to regulate plant growth and improves coloration and then accelerate ripening of fruits. So, with this compound, mas dali maka-regulate ang ato ang mango trees, mas dali siya maka-reproduce. And with potassium nitrate as fertilizer, mas dali ang development sa ato mangga. So as far as I know, based on my reference, it was said that these two elements is capable of making the mango trees produce itself maskin paog dili niya season. So if i-apply nimo ni silang mga compounds, imuhang mangga possible nga na siya'y high in development siya. So mas improve siya sa ubang mangga nga walay ethyl and potassium nitrate. Usually ginagamit niya siya sa mga katong producer sa mangga. Next we have Josefino Cacas Comiso. He is a Filipino physicist who is capable of monitoring the Arctic through a satellite. So, Dr. Josefino was the person to discover a recurring pollinia in the cosmonaut sea in the south of the Indian Ocean. So, he has been leading a physical scientist with the Goddard Flight Center and NASA science since in 1979. So, what is pollinia? Pollinia is a semi-permanent area of open water in sea ice. So, kanina ay water, muna na siya ang melted ice. So, nganong nag-melt? Due to high temperature on Earth, ang mga ice sa Arctic Ocean pwede sila magkahinay-hinay og melt. So in 2002, he reported that sea ice cover in the Arctic was declining rapidly. So paspas na iyang melting. So by the following year, naobserbahan na po niya nga ang temperature sa Arctic was rising 3 times faster than it was due to ice albedo feedback. So ang ice albedo feedback is mono siya. So representation ni siya sa ice albedo feedback nga ang the more heat nga maigo dito sa Arctic, the more warmer ang ato ang Earth. Pero if Arctic Ocean wala na siya ice, ang ato ang Earth masunog na pod siya kasi ang ice mo na siya ang nagabalance sa warmer sa ato ang sa Earth. So next we have Jose Bihar Cruz. So Dr. Cruz is a computer engineering and he is also known for his theory and practice of automatic control. So unsa ba ni mga automatic control? So ang mga automatic control like circuits, network, automatic control, so he is also known for the practice of automatic control. So muni ang iha mga na contributes aside sa automatic control. So dili lang day automatic control ang iyang i-practice. But also circuits, network, dynamic games and incentive strategy. So with his contribution with what he had contributed na improve ang ato ang technology diri sa Philippines. Even ang even when it comes with business managing. So fourth is Dr. Lourdes Jansoy Cruz. She is a Filipino biochemist known as the sea snail venom specialist. So her research has contributed to understanding of biochemistry of toxic peptides from the venom of fish hunting Conus marine snails. So also contributed to the development of conotoxins as tools for examining the activity of the human brain. So elaborate kung unsa man ni ang Conus marine snails, unsa din na siya. So ang Conus marine snails or cone snails, these are venomous which is capable of stinging using their modified radula tooth and a venom gland to attack and paralyze their prey. So nganong gigamit maning cone snails So unsa man ang connect the eye sa cone snails sa activity sa ato ang brain. So ang cone snails manggod kay na siya conotoxins, which is bioactive peptides found in the venom of the marine cone snails used as pharmacological tools. So, gamit din yung conotoxin as medicine para ma-study ang pain signaling and have the potential to become new class of analgesics. So, develop ang conotoxins because naasyay bioactive peptides. So, muna siya ang bioactive peptides nga kinahanglan sa ato ang brain pag magsakit. So, ang conotoxins nga, isa sa mga tambal nga na yung conotoxins kay kaning priyalt. So, ang priyalt is, mura po ni siya og, So, next we have Dr. Fabian Millar Dairit. He is known for his research in herbal medicine. He established the National Chemistry Instrumentation Center. So, he did the phytochemical work for the development of Lagundi. So, sa tabang ni Dr. Dairit, sa una, sa wala pa'y Lagundi, kay, lisod kayong, mangita og tambal para sa ubo. Daw na may uban nga medicine nga para sa ubo, pero kinahanglan siya og prescription sa doktor. Unlike sa Lagundi nga pwede ra nimo siya mapalit without kaning reseta. So ang Lagundi manggod kay pwede siya maka treat og wounds, headaches, ulcers, skin disease, diarrhea, and common cold. So, mostly sa ato kay ginagamit na natong Lagundi pag or ginainom natong Lagundi if naatay kanang ubo. Next, we have Dr. Rafael D. Guerrero. So, Dr. Rafael Guerrero was recognized because of his scientific and technical contributions to the growth of sex reversal and hatchery techniques that help the commercial fabrication of high-yielding market-sized tilapia in the Philippines and other nations. So, we all know nga ang tilapia, muna siya isa sa mga dali kayo ibaligya. Muna siya taas kayo og isa po sa taas og demand labi na dali sa Pilipinas kay mahilig. Ganahan ba po ta og tilapia din. Nindot po ang production sa tilapia kasi ang tilapia, dali siya mu-adapt o development. So, muna siya nga, ang gihimo ni Dr. Guerrero, nagkadak siya og sex reversal, pero diligent na siya literally nga reversal from male to himuon siya og female. Dali siya nga naana. Ang ihang ginapasabot nga sex reversal is to improve the sex reproduction sex reproductive system sa tilapia. So mostly ang ginabaligya nga tilapia is katong mga laki kay ang laki manggod dagko sila and then mas dali pud sila mo-develop unlike sa babayi. So, tilapia is more efficient in aquaculture as it can grow faster than the females, di ba? In tilapia, sex reversal, the undifferentiated fry are fed with synthetic androgen. So, ang synthetic androgen, muna siya ang synthetic, when we talk about synthetic, kay medicine na siya. And androgen is male. Estrogen is female, di ba? So, synthetic androgen, muna siya ang medicine para mo develop og paspas ang ato ang male tilapia. Okay. sa Manisha. So, with the contribution of Dr. Guerrero, mas na-enhance pa jud ang ato ang techniques kung paunsa i-develop ang mga tilapia, kung unsaon pag padaghan sa pagpadaghan sa mga tilapia okay. Number 7, we have Dr. Enrique Mapua Ostrella Jr. So, he is the inventor of neonatal drug test. He has been recognized as a leading pioneer in the field of pediatrics. So, he developed meconium drug test to detect the presence of illegal substances in newborns. And one of the top 20, and he is one of the top 20 most influential pregnancy experts. So, muni siya ang meconium drug test. Okay, meconium drug test. This test reveals exposures to drugs, tobacco smoke, alcohol, and other environmental toxicants. So, kani siya is muni siya ang feces sa baby, newborn baby. First poop. Pag ingon ani ang taes sa baby, paggawas niya, then pagkalibang niya, ingon na na iyahang tae, pasabot nga ang iyahang mama na asyay or exposed siya sa kanang daghan kayong medicines, and then possible nga naka-inhale or gagamit siya og kanang cigarettes or tobacco smoke, and then exposed po siya sa alcohol, and then exposed po siya sa kanang polluted area. So ang mahitabo kung affected ang baby. So if ang meconium or kaninga feces kay dili siya, kung dili ni siya magawas sa bata, possible nga ang bata pwede siya mamatay due to poisoning. So, next, we have Dr. Lilian Formalejo Patenya. She is a biochemist who discovered a breed of calamansi and seedless pomelo and discovered micropropagation, which established the banana industry in the Philippines. So, siya ang nagpalago sa banana industry sa Pilipinas through micropropagation and tissue culture. So, ang micropropagation kasi, it is the practice of taking extremely small pieces of plant tissue chosen from a prepared mother plant. Then, gina-undergo ni siya or gina-observe lang ni siya sa laboratory. Muna siyang ginatawag siya og micropropagation. Then, ang tissue culture is muna siya ang starting step sa micropropagation, where plant cells or organs are grown on a nutrient medium, whereas micropropagation is the production of thousands of identical plantlets. So, muna siya ang gihimo ni Dr. Lilian para mapalago niya ang production sa banana. Okay, next we have Dr. Marijo Panginiban Ruiz. She is a Filipino mathematician and a professor of mathematics at Ateneo de Manila University with her specialization in graph theory. So one of her abilities was to spot talent in her colleagues and put them to work in the different committees. So she is very thoughtful with her students, as what I have read on one of her students' articles nga gi-upload sa Google. So she said that Dr. Marijo encouraged her to teach at Ateneo de Manila, because Dr. Marijo seen that she is capable of kaning understanding graph theory. So muto siya ang plan ni Dr. Marijo para sa iyang estudyante, iyang encourage nga mag-teach sa Ateneo. So through Dr. Marijo Panginiban Ruiz and her specialization in graph theory, na-relay siya sa atoa. Then enhance pang atoa knowledge about graph theories. Okay. Next, we have Dr. Gregory Ligo Tangonan. He is known for his research in the field of communication technology. His research and inventions in the field of science and technology operate in space, on aircraft, in automobiles, and in variety of consumer products that make our world safer, support our national security, and improve our quality of life. So, isa sa mga inventions ni Dr. Gregory Tangonan nga makita nato diri sa Philippines is ang antennas. So, nayo duha ka kind of antennas, which is the analog and the digital antenna. Ang analog, muni siya ang katungkaraan bitaw nga ginagamit nato sa atoa. Muni siya ang ginatawag nga cable. So, di ba, kung muni siya ang poste sa cable. Okay, sa katong wala pa ang signal, wala pa ang GSAT, wala pa ang Sky. So, muni siya ginagamit. Muna siya ginatawag nga analog antenna. So, kaning digital antenna, muna na siya ang kaning modern, kaning mga ginagamit na to karon nga signal, Sky, o GSAT. So, usay differences day sa analog o digital. So, ang analog, it has lower frequency siya, pero continuous ang iyahang electrical signal. Diba? Unlike sa digital antenna, is limited na nga to ang electrical signal. Kung diba kasi ang kaning digital antenna is for example, ang signal, ginaloadan lang nato siya, diba? If ma-expire na ang load, so dili na ta makalantaw og daghang channel. Naagi hapo yung mga channels nga mush show up, pero kato mga channels nga gusto nato lang tawon like ABS-CBN, mga Cartoon Networks, dili na nato sila makita if dili na po ta mag-reload. Unlike sa analog antenna, sa cable, bayad lang ta diretso dito, then dili continuous na siya ang iyahang signal. Okay. So nganong makakommunicate man ta through these antennas. So ang hinungdan ana is ang fiber optics. So optical fiber is used by telecommunication companies to transmit telephone signals, internet communication, and cable television signals. So muna siya ang iyahang image. Muna siya ang fiber optics. Nana siya sa wire. Okay. Next, we have Dr. Cesar A. Saloma. He is a professor of the National Institute of Physics. He led the development of of a method to generate high contrast images of semiconductor sites via one photon optical beam induced current imaging and confocal reflectance microscopy. So with his contribution, naka-receive siya og Galileo Galilei Award from International Commission for Optics. So mo ni ang ihang na na develop nga microscopy na asyay layer laser. So mo ni siya ang one photon optical beam and the two photon optical beam. Okay, kani siya nga microscope is improvised lang ni siya. Unlike atong microscope nga ginagamit na to put sa laboratory. Pero kato siya is dili lang to siya ni mo siya dili lang to nimo ma ma-connect sa computer, pero kaning semiconductor is pwede nimo ni siya ma-connect para mas ma-emphasize ang katong organism nga imuhang ginastudyahan. Okay, so next we have Edgardo Gomez. He is recognized for his contributions in marine ecosystems, coral reef ecology, and conservation, re-establishment of giant clam stocks, and marine science capability enhancement. So he led the world's first national scale assessment of damage to coral reefs, leading to international conservation initiatives such as the replanting of corals. So ang gihimo ni Dr. Gomez is iyahang gireplant ang katong mga daot bitong coral reefs para magamit gihapon sa mga isda as shelter. Okay. Now, William Padolina. Dr. William Padolina was also a biotechnologist that have led to significant, okay. He is excellent for his research in leadership and promotion of natural products, chemistry, and biotechnology, which have led to significant growth and development in these fields in the Philippines. So he is recognized for his significant contributions in the field of natural products chemistry, in coconut chemistry, biotechnology, and in management of research and development. So, ang iyang like Dr. Lilian, kung si Dr. Lilian is na ang develop sa banana through biotechnology, si Dr. William siya pod ang nagdevelop sa improvement sa coconut through chemistry and biotechnology. So, muna yung iyahang contributions, isolation and identification of new germacranulide sesquiterpene lactones with complex structural features, including bioactive compounds from Philippine medicinal plants with anti-allergy and insecticidal activity, and two others, coconut new derivatives from coconut fatty acids, and he led the development of biotechnology as a researcher and as a leader. Next, we have Dr. Angel Alcala. So, si Dr. Angel Alcala, isa po niya siya ka-biologist. Ang iyahang expertise po ani is with the coral reef. So, siya po ang duo ni Dr. Guerrero sa pag replant sa coral reef. So, silang duha ang nag-unite para sa kanang ikabubuti sa ato ang coral reefs para na ikapuy-an lang jud ang ato ang isda. So sila ang nag-maintain pud ana nga practice. So he was named a national scientist of the Philippines by President Benigno S. Aquino III in 2014 for his work on marines, protected areas, and herpetology. Next, we have... Okay, wala na di ay. So, paunsa man ta mahimo scientist? Actually, tanang tawo pwede mahimo scientist. Because... the individual interest, we have the individual interest in science. And even our family, nag-share po sa ato og unsay laha mga knowledge sa science. Then, makuha po na to ang knowledges about science through natural environment. So, these three factors, makuha na to ni siya sa school science, where the teachers give us the learnings about environment. And then, if a person wants to further enhance his knowledge, then he should proceed in the science laboratory para ma-exceed pa jud ang iyahang knowledge. Then, saka siya mahimong Filipino scientist or scientist. So, muro to siya. Thank you.